amino acid with uncharged polar side chains. So which are the amino acids with uncharged polar side chains? Close your eyes, think about it. Uncharged polar, that includes hydroxyl containing amino acids, which is serine, threonine, tyrosine, and we have asparagine and glutamine, right? So amino acid with uncharged polar side chains include serine, threonine, tyrosine with the hydroxyl groups, asparagine and glutamine with the amide group, right? So what are the uses of these hydroxyl group and the amide groups? So the importance of uncharged polar side chains are they help in forming hydrogen bonds. So hydrogen bonds here include serine, threonine and tyrosine's hydroxyl groups. So they're contributing to hydrogen bonds, serine, threonine, tyrosine, hydroxyl groups. And the amide group of asparagine and glutamine also help in forming hydrogen bonds. So that is the first use. The second use of the uncharged polar side chains are for attachment of various other groups to the amino acids. Like if I have to attach a phosphate group, if I say phosphorylation of proteins, right? So we have phosphoproteins in nature. So how do I attach a phosphate group to a protein? That is basically by using these R groups, that is either the hydroxyl groups or we can use the other groups, right? So predominantly we will be using the hydroxyl groups for attaching the phosphates. So hydroxyl groups here are basically present in serine, threonine and tyrosine. So attachment for phosphate. If I say serine and threonine, that is